Hi everyone, it's Steve Martin from sidemounting.com. This video I think you'll find really interesting. I hope it will educate a lot of divers. And the reason I'm making this video is to raise awareness about how different equipment performs on your body. You'll see here we've got three divers, three different fins. You've got one positive, one neutral, and one fin in the background there that's negative. So I want you to think about these fins being on your feet. They all perform differently, so they're going to have a different effect on your feet, thus affecting your trim. Most divers never stop moving while they're underwater, so they don't really understand what the fin's doing on their foot. It all matters when you do a trim check and you relax everything using a streamlined piece of equipment. As you relax, you breathe shallowly, and then you see what happens to those fins. And if they rise, then that means they were rising all the time and you were counteracting that as you swim. Here's another example, me again with slightly heavier fins this time. As I relax, the change is slow, but they're definitely not positive like they were in the other video. These are definitely slightly negative. Of course, if you're a skilled diver, you can tolerate any small differences. Ideally, what you're looking for is that when you relax and shallowly breathe, nothing moves up or down. Now the fin is going to give you the maximum efficiency as you use it. We're now going to look at different fins to give you a better understanding. The fin that's negative there is a Dive Systems jet fin. The neutral fin is a Mares Quattro with a standard bungee strap. Now we have the Dive Systems and another Mares Quattro, but this time with a steel spring strap. And you can see both fins are actually negative now. Again, the same test. If you're looking to add a little more weight, then the spring strap is a good idea. If your fin is too heavy, then you just need to change the fin. This is an Apex RK3, and quite amazingly, this fin is quite positive. Even though it's a jet fin, the rubber they're using makes this fin very positive on the foot. During your trim check, if you find your legs are heavy, then the RK3 might be a good idea to get buoyancy back in the legs, which is very unlikely if you're using a dry suit. So fins have lots of different buoyancy characteristics, but they also perform very differently as well. I've started testing many different types of fins. I'm currently making reviews about each fin, and they will be available through my online training video series. All the fins shown in this video are fully reviewed and tested. If you have more suggestions, let me know. The jet fin on the left is a UTD fin, and that's negative. I found being this short, it really affected my finning style. Slightly negative fins tend to sit with the fin tits up, and the jet fin you can see lies completely flat. Again, we have the RK3 compared to the Dive Systems. It's quite a difference in those two. Just think about that same diver now wearing either one of those fins. There'll be quite a difference in how it affects their trim, which is definitely going to affect how they kick and their efficiency when moving underwater. Another very positive fin was the Hollis F2. You can see here. This one has comparable buoyancy to the RK3 from Apex. It's not just your fins that affect the buoyancy around your body. These boots had been used for about 6 months. When I first got them, they were positively buoyant, then they became negative. You'll also find that different thicknesses of wetsuit will also affect your buoyancy and trim. What's interesting is the thermocline material from Fourth Element. I found that this was always generally neutral or slightly negative. This is useful because you can add more insulation to keep warmer, but not necessarily affect your buoyancy. Now I'm going to show you an interesting test I have with my wetsuit boots. This is the pelagic boot from Fourth Element. And you can see that, yeah, it's been used this one, probably for around 6 months of diving. And this one is kind of neutral to ever so slightly negative. This is how the boot performs with my fin on. so you can see fairly neutral, just hanging there. This is great if my wetsuit is very neutral on my body, which it is. If the wetsuit made my legs rise, then a heavier fin might be more suitable. The boots I'm just testing out now are a fairly new pair of amphibian boots, and these ones are pretty much the same, but they have a much thicker sole. We'll compare them now. You can see there quite a difference in the sole, and you can see clearly one is quite positive and the other is neutral to slightly negative. So you can see it's not just the fins, everything you wear will have an impact on your buoyancy. Here is the same thicker soled boot inside the fin, and you can see this makes my negative fin now quite positive. Now I've added one bolt snap to the buoyant boot, and you can see it's still rising. I'll add a second bolt snap, and you can see it's slowed down but still rising. If I take a third bolt snap, the boot is now performing just like the other one, neutral to slightly negative. Here I'll show you that the actual lift is right from the sole. You see it flips up there. When you compare the two boots together now, you see they're both very similar. So next I try adding bolt snaps to the buoyant fin, and you can see that with one bolt snap it slowed a little but still positive. Add a second bolt snap, and you can see now it's neutral. So now you can go ahead and test the boots and fins and all the equipment you have. You'll get a better idea of how it's performing on you. I hope this video helps you make the right equipment choices in the future. If you found this interesting and like to see more videos like this, as well as learn to side mount correctly, then check out my online training materials. All details are on sidemounting.com. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and thanks again to everybody who's invested in my online training videos so far. It's much appreciated, and I look forward to bringing more in the future. Cheers, guys.